what would you say, so just in terms, just conceptually, if I let my viscosity go from 0 to infinity, what am I describing? What transition is that describing? If I let viscosity go from 0 to infinity, what is that describing?
Gas to solid?
Pretty much. Essentially, I mean, even gas even has a little bit of viscosity, sort of. There's some, I don't know. You have to have things really spread out that there's no friction whatsoever in your material. So there isn't really any such thing as zero viscosity. That's an idealized case. Right? But yeah, letting it go to infinity, you're translating from a liquid into a solid. Or potentially gas into a solid. Alright, so one last thing on fluid mechanics. We talked about turbulence, and I said briefly that it gets very complex, so we're not going into it. But at low flow speeds, the flow of fluid the flow of fluid at a given viscosity is laminar. So what that means is that it all sort of flows together in the same direction. What laminar really means is that you imagine it to have. Let me think of a good example. So you imagine a bunch of pieces of paper, okay? And let's say each of the pieces of paper, they're in a stack. Each of the pieces of paper represents some flowing water, right? When I have the stack nicely stacked together, I have a nice laminar flow. I have all the flows that are sort of lining up together, and so each of them is represented by a plane, and if I laminate those together, all together, that's going to give me some volume of flow through some area. All right, so if I stick all those together, that's what we mean by laminar flow. A turbulent flow would be I crumpled up all those pieces of paper so that now all the directions of the paper are all jumbled up, right? And I no longer have a nice flow through some volume. Okay? So that's my analogy for laminar versus turbulent. All right. So that is the end.